How's it going, everybody? Peter here, and a warm welcome to another retro train set review. And this one is a Hornby R851. And I'll just check that on my phone because the reference number has been covered by a sticker, but I can confirm that the reference number of this Hornby 00 gauge freight hauler train set is R851. So this is the retro train set review to come of August 2023. As you know, folks, I do these once a month, and I do have a big one that will be coming in a review next month. So for this month of August, I thought we would rewind to 1995, and this one is the freight hauler. It is mostly complete and it's not complete, and I will explain this. In fact, I've had to borrow some track from another train set, which will be coming up next month for the review. For the reasons is that this track is what I'm borrowing, and it's not in the box, as the track that did come with it is not from this train set, so it's not got the original integrity. But I might explain why I got this one for a good deal. Of course, this one is an eBay purchase, and it is one of the pitfalls of when buying pre-owned. But that said, you can get some very good train sets that are in immaculate condition pre-owned as well. So it's kind of a double-edged sword, metaphorically speaking, in terms of buying pre-owned Hornby model train sets. This one dates from 1995, and that was the year where they moved away from styrene trays to these plastic trays. Although it was short-lived, because back in 1996, a year later, most of the Hornby train sets did revert back to the golden coloured styrene trays, as shown in last month's review that we did of Tunnel Freight. Okay, so what I'm going to do, as this is the introduction, and I just want to get that out of the way, we will move on to the unboxing part, as I really do like these retro train sets. So just to show you the details and stuff, by the way, although this image does show the Hornby R921 train controller, this was not included with this train set, and the tray is even designed to accommodate the newer, at the time in 1995, the Hornby R965 train controller. And this is what you would get if you bought a pristine version of this train set. Although the crossing gates are included, the level crossing base is not, so it will be just an oval of track, and we will run this using the Hornby R965 train controller, as that does work and everything does work as intended, or at least it was when I tried it. But if not, what I'll do, I'll just do what I did with the last train set, and I'll just revert to my trusty Hornby R914. But there you go, folks. And even tells you the requirements. 44 inches by 31. And yes, folks, this is first radius curve. So let's place this down here then. And I will steer the camera so it's pointing down. And let's get the lid off and let's have a look at what this train set has then. So what I had to do, I have had to repair the lid with some sticky tape. And as you can see there, not sure if I've got that in the position, but the original reference label has been covered by this one. So I'm assuming this could have come from somewhere like Argos or something back in the day. I don't know. Or Toys R Us even, as they did sell a lot of these Hornby train sets. In fact, I'm just going to prop that over there, move the lid out of the way, and just move this back just so you can see what's in the train set itself then. Okay, first of all, it does come with paperwork. It's about the Hornby 040 engines, and it tells you how to clean them, maintenance and all that good stuff. Nothing on the back, and you've got instructions for the level crossing, but as I said at the start, folks, mine didn't come with a crossing, so we will be omitting that one. And we've got this warranty repair card back from 1995, so there you go. Interesting times. And we do have this guarantee, and if we just have a look at the date here, folks, this was when it was stamped. Well, I think this is off another train set, as this one has R390, so just look that up on Google or something and you will find out what that actually belongs to. And it does say here the 11th of October 1995, so I don't know what that's off, but the R number is definitely not from this train set, as the R number for this one is R851. So that's the paperwork all done. So it's now time to move on to the track, and I'll show you what I mean. This is not the original 1995 track, as they did use the brass coloured nickel silver track as well. This one, this is the old steel track, and it has seen better days, and this is possibly from the 1970s, if not the 1960s. As you can tell, it's got the older style semi sleepers just to hide the join. So I think that's from the 1970s, if not the 1960s. But we will not be using this in this test run, although everything else does work. And I'll tell you something, this 040 steam engine, it runs like a rocket. And that's why they used to be called pocket rockets, because when I was a kid, I used to have a few of these Hornby pocket rocket steam engines, and they used to go like a rocket. So you put them on a layout and they just literally take off if you're not careful with them. And this is one of the made in England models as well. So we do have the locomotive numbered as, I believe that says 49. Correction, 43. Named as Queen Mary in this Clipso red colour with the gold bands around the saddle tank, I believe it is. And quite a fun looking locomotive. And you do get some freight cars that are based on the period, but the two freight cars of the Yeoman and the BP tanker, that's more for present day. So what else do we get, folks? We got four straights, and we will use these as these are salvageable. And again, this is a blend of the brass, nickel, silver and the standard steel track. And these came with the set as is. And I just cleaned these up with a track rubber, because when I did unbox this, they were quite disgusting. So I just did some prep work before doing this unboxing and review of this train set. Okay, so we've got the blue coloured freight car. And by the way, folks, this is not original. I believe this is Triang, but it was included in the train set. And that might explain why I got this one quite cheap. So I may try and source a brown coloured wagon as original, which was an iron ore wagon, as shown on the drawing and on the picture, on the box lid. So this is not original, this is just an extra. And down here, we do have this Yeoman, a Yeoman hopper, and this would go behind something like a Class 56 or a Class 59 or something. And it is modern, 1990s, 1980s anyways. And again, nice mouldy detail, and this is made in England as well. Okay, so moving on to the tank car of this one. And I'm thankful that this one does include its original ladder as well, so that's all grand. Couplings and everything are complete, along with the plastic wheels and stuff, and it is made in England. Just like all the models are in this train set, as it dates from 1995. And we'll just bring this up. We do have our 4-ton Esso tank car, and it's in quite good condition actually. No damage to the lattice struts, they're all intact as well. This has the red Esso tacks, so that's all grand. All couplings and wheels are intact as well, so that's happy days. Okay, so we'll just move on to the brake van, or the caboose as it's known in some countries. So this is the brake van, or the caboose, and that's in the LMS colours as well. So very nice model all round, and I do like the fact that the red light has been painted on the back too. Nice touch. So let's flip that round and have it the right way then. All couplings and wheels are complete, so we do have a nice basic freight train. And we shall now move on to the controller. This is a two-part controller, as this is one of the newer ones at the time. This is the R964 transformer, and this steps it down from 240 volts to a safe 15 volts at 5 variamps. So this is also made in England before production was moved to China a year later. Okay, so we've got the second part, and possibly, in my opinion, one of the best train set controllers that Hornby has ever made. And this one is the Hornby R965 train controller. And this is one of the older made in England Mark 1 R965 train controllers, as the Mark 2s were produced in China, and they have a slightly different text layout on the top. And you'll see what I mean. And I do have a made in China controller, of which I may do a comparison in the future, so you will know what to look for. But I do like these retro train sets anyways. And we do have the 15 volts AC output for signals and stuff from these two terminals here. Although sadly, one of the retaining bolts is missing. So, and it's not in the box, so it is as it is, and that's how it came to me today, at the time I'm doing this review anyways. Okay folks, not quite done yet, so just going to move this tissue, and these are the accessories that did come in the train set, and it is mostly complete apart from the level crossing bases. We do have the two crossing gates, but sadly I can't use these in the setup because I don't have the bases with it, hence why I got this one quite cheap. So we've got the crossings. We do have the two power connecting clips, so that's all grand. Several different style telegraph poles, and these just clip into the track if you want to use these, and I may just slot them into the track just for good effect. And we do have this overhead wagon gauge thing, and we do have a water tower, well, another telegraph pole, and we do have the water crane. So it's a very nice set in my opinion. And for whatever odd reason is as well, we do have a person and a moped. So I don't think these were included in the train set from new. These are just extras that the previous seller put in the box, so that's thoughtful. And we do have another pole, a mast, correction, a stand for whatever you may want to use those for. And we do have a whistle board, so that's all grand. And I think that is a driver or a fireman, and that goes into the locomotive. So you do get quite a lot of accessories, and there is some mile posts all still sealed in the bag. I won't be using these, so no bother there. So folks, you do get quite a lot of accessories in this train set, and I do apologise for my voice keep breaking up. I'm going to have another glass of water before I proceed with this setup, and then I will be back shortly, so just bear with me. Okay folks, and now I'm back. I just want to say something just to clarify, as I did mention at the start of this retro train set review. We are using some track that I've borrowed from another train set, because sadly the included track is not fit for purpose, but I've cleaned it up with a track rubber and this is all ready to go. So just like before folks, just going to lay that there, and just to protect the train from the carpet burrs and stuff, I will use A4 sheets of paper just to make a nice layer, as there is no track mat included with this train set, so it is what it is, and I want to keep this as organic as possible. And fingers crossed, I'm going to use the included train controller. So what we'll do, I'm just going to stop the video, set up the track off camera, and let's have some serious fun then. Okay folks, we've now got the track all set up and ready to go. There's a few teething issues with this train set, and the reason is that the Yeoman wagon does keep derailing at random intervals. I think the reason for that is that this track is just too tight radius for it, and it doesn't like to stay on the track. But do you know what? I'm going to try and run it, and I'm pleased to say that I'm using this Hornby R965 train controller. So, as you can hear by the buzzing current from the track, so if I put it in neutral, that shuts that off, but when you put it into forwards, it does send current to the track straight away. And I've used some of the lineside accessories, as you may see the whistle board there too. And to be quite frankly honest, my advice when purchasing pre-owned train sets and stuff, if you're not sure on anything, just ask the seller, is there any new track, or does the track need to be replaced or anything? And the chances are, if the seller is honest, they will tell you straight up, because I do. I do actually sell on places like eBay myself, but I've always been honest and straight up with any potential buyers, because that's just the way I am. And in truth folks, this is a nice train set overall, although to be quite frankly honest, if I didn't have any track available, I would have contacted the seller and asked him about the track and stuff, but thankfully I do have some spare tracks, so I'm lucky. But in truth, if in doubt and you're just starting out in the world of 00 gauge model trains folks, just purchase some R605 first radius curves if you don't have a lot of space. This looper track doesn't use too much room, and you can probably tell by the colour track in the background, as you may see that uses about 7 foot by 4, and that's just laid on the floor here. And I've laid all the track on A4 sheets of paper just to protect the train from any burrs and fluff and stuff, although I do keep my floor clean and that as well. But I do go that extra mile just to do these retro train sets, and I'm pleased to say that the locomotive does work. I've put some fresh oil on it and it does run really well. And by the way, this train set is 28 years old, as it was released in 1995, I believe. And also, I do have some plans to go through some retro Hornby brochures again, as I do like to go through retro model trains, as I do find these older train sets absolutely fascinating. So folks, we've been talking for a bit. Let's just run this train. I will continue to talk to you, but I want you to see just how lively this locomotive really is. And the thing is, this track, it is quite old, but I can't guarantee that this hopper won't derail. But all in all, if you were starting out and you are modelling on a budget, I would recommend, just as a backup plan, purchase new track, or almost new pre-owned track, because then if you do purchase a train set like this and you get the original track, which is not really the original track that came with this train set when it was released in 1995, it would be this track here, folks, that I'm using now, and I've had to borrow that from another train set just so I can do this demonstration. And I'm not sure why this freight car keeps randomly derailing, but we're going to carry on, as I don't give up and I don't give in, and I'm not going to keep stopping and starting the train. Things are going to cooperate, so I'm just going to ignore that and carry on talking to you. But anyways, I'll just try and re-rail that on the fly for you. But all in all, this is a 28 year old model train set, and it does run great for its age. Obviously, just like with all new and pre-owned model trains, just give them a run for about 30 to 45 minutes in each direction, folks, as then that will allow the driveline and the gearing to bed in. I think the problem is that there is the brake van, or the caboose, is quite heavy, and it is pulling the back of the freight car off the track. So I will try and re-rail that on the fly. There we go. Let's got that back on the track for now. Let's increase the power then. Let's assume we go a wee bit faster. But honestly, it does really run great. And all I'm going to say is, by the way, when purchasing pre-owned train sets like this, just exercise caution, as although the majority of sellers are honest and they know their stuff, some of these train sets have probably spent decades in the attic or the loft and probably haven't been used for years and years. So it is possible that the seller may not know anything about these model trains at all, but if in doubt, just buy some brand new set track, as then that will be brand new and you won't have any problems with missing fish plates, of which they are known as the connectors that connects the track all together and stuff. So as you can see there, folks, apart from that freight car, it does run really great. In fact, I'm going to try something here. I'll take this freight car off and just bear with me. Just going to take that freight car off, see how we go with that. Or I may reshuffle the consoles. I'm going to try and move the freight car forward a bit. Just see if that helps anything. As you know, I don't give up. I don't give in. We'll see how that works. Let's see how we get on with that. I'll just move the freight cars around. Let's see how we get on with that then. And I've only got this on about not even a quarter of the way. I think that's about probably 20% par. And this tank engine really wants to take off. Now the tank car's playing up, honestly. Okay, I'll get a message. So that will do. We'll just try that one more time now. Okay. Anyways, as you can tell, the locomotive is settling in nicely now, and it is running, starting to run a lot smoother than it was. Although it's not silky smooth, because it is a direct motor to a large gear on the front. And I did put some fresh lubricant on that, but these tank engines are not really designed for smoothness. It's just a basic train set, and it is designed just to have lots of fun with. So folks, what do you think to these older train sets then? I will be doing another one in September. In fact, I'm going to turn that power up a wee bit, as it is a bit, it's kind of slack in there, but. Okay, we've got two off here, so. Well, that's the fun with model trains, folks. And this proves, and even on my N-scale model railway, not everything runs to plan. And in truth, we've got another derailment there as well. But I'm going to keep going. But I think the reason is that this is old track. Apart from the curved track, it's mostly the straights that are playing up the most, as it does derail on the straights. But I have got all the fish plates and everything are lined up, and the best connector that I can do. Right, I'm giving up. I'm going to have one smooth lap at least. So we'll see who will win here. Okay. Let's see how we get on with that then. So just carrying on here, folks. There we go. Because it's old track, it does tend to come away. Although I could always use pliers just to tighten up the fish plates if I want to, but I think in truth, if I was to have this from the get-go, I'd just replace all the track and stuff. But anyways, I think it's now time to start winding this video down, because this train is just not playing ball at all, and to be honest, it's just getting quite annoying. So that's just the precautions when buying pre-owned, okay? Anyway folks, it's time to start winding down this video. Please do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other, all the best, and I will see yous with another retro train set review coming in September. And thanks for watching. Oh, by the way folks, I nearly forgot to mention, out of a rating of 1 to 10, for a train set of this condition, I'll probably give it around a 7. But if this was being reviewed in 1995, I would very likely give this train set around an 8 out of 10. As to be quite frankly honest, it is a great train set for what it is. It's just the condition of the track, as it does derail on the straight tracks, and it's because of the age of the tracks and stuff. And if you are new to model trains and that, and you're starting off on the pre-owned route, If in doubt, just ask the seller the condition of the track and if it's fit for use. If it's not described in the description, I tend to do that, and on the whole, I would recommend pre-owned model trains, as there is some train sets out there that are older and they are just as good as buying new. Anyway folks, so I thought I'd give this a 7 out of 10. I forgot to do that when I was winding the video down. That's the end of this review. Big thank you for watching. Take care of yourselves and each other, and I will see you. And if you're here for the retro train set reviews, I will be back in September for that. But for the regular videos, I'll catch you in the next one.